students, welcome to the session of remote sensing and GIS. So till now we have discussed the enhancement processes, the image arithmetic operations, and how is digital image processed in the computer software. Now, after doing the analysis of enhancement as per our requirement, we are going to see how is spatial filtering given and what are the image classification technique. So first of all, let us discuss about the spatial filtering. What is spatial filtering? So basis on the pre-processing and the processing, here we are going to detect the edges, and according to the edges we are going to analyze for what reason it is required, which is also known as high pass and low pass. So basically, if I can give you here the example of spatial filtering, which is also known as convolution, here the edges are then the softness, smoothness of the edges, and also edges are sharpened. So basically in the area, if I want to do any analysis, then this convolution is given, which is known as high pass and low pass, and according to my analysis of area, I can do the spatial filtering. So basically you can see here the processing of suppressing certain frequencies is being done for the specific analysis only. Convolutions of various matrices are also provided. You can say 7:7, 5:5, 3:3, as per my requirement of study area, what features I want to identify particularly in the pixel intensities. Student understand what area of my feature is to be particularly identified, I am going to apply this convolution. You can see how is image now enhanced, right? And then according to that pixel values, I am going to classify my image, which is known as convolution. So basically it is known as spatial filtering. We have the matrices in maths. Accordingly, here also for spatial filtering we are giving different matrices according to the feature extraction what we require. Now we are going to discuss a new topic which is very important, known as image classification. What is image classification? Basically, image classification is required because every time we the human cannot identify the features of the image, that what is urban, what is vegetation, how much area is covered in urban, how much area is covered in vegetation, what is fallow land, wetland, wastelands, right? Every time manually we cannot calculate, and it sometimes misinterpret also. That is why we required image classification technique. What is image classification technique? Basically, the pattern analysis, which is art of finding out what is the neighboring pixels value and how is these pixels can be identified. So pattern recognition is very important. You have to recognize the patterns of various features, that is water body, that is wasteland, urban, etc. And then we can do the whole area calculation of our area, which is known as pattern recognition, which is the very basic process of classification. We also have the training samples. What are training samples? So in an image, if I want to give the various classes in my image, I have to select the training samples. Means I have to give the command to the software that if the pixel values are these, it should be considered as wasteland or vegetation, which is known as training samples. Means samples are selected by us, by the analyst, and then it will provide us the whole image classification according to what samples and classes we have derived, right? Now let us discuss the image classification methodology, which is very important to discuss, that how is image classification done, what are the analysis behind it, why it is done, and how is image classified, and what are the techniques applied to the image. First of all, let us see here that you have to select the area, the data from where or for which satellite you are downloading. After downloading, you have to take the data for 2 years. After taking that, you have to do the layer stacking of the data. Means what? A data has numbers of bands, so I have to do the stacking of it. Doing stacking of it, I will be now doing what? Clipping the area or region which I want to classify, that this region contains how much vegetation or how much water body area into it. Then I am going to select what? I am going to select now the classification methodology. There are two types of methodology. First methodology is known as supervised classification, and second methodology is known as unsupervised classification. So according to my study area, I am going to apply it. selecting numbers of classes, what classes I want to give, how much classes I want to give. After giving that, after doing the classification methodology, then I am going to do what? Post classification analysis, and after that I am going to do the accuracy assessment of what image is classified. So this is the whole methodology which we have discussed. Now let us discuss about the supervised classification technique. What is supervised classification technique? Basically, in supervised classification technique, we, the analyst, going to give the classes in our image. What is that? Now please make your attention towards the background of PPT. You can see here a satellite image being shown. Here you can see the color wise I am going to give the classes. Means black color I am going to give the water body. Red color I am going to give the vegetation. Blue color I am going to give the urban area. White color I am going to give the wastelands. So these are the classes of features, classes in the image, that is what is being decided by me. I am recognizing the pattern and I am giving the input in the technique, which is known as supervised classification. So basically we have the image, then we have the supervised training samples. The classes which I am giving is known as training samples. Then I have what? Pixel labeling. How much classes I am selecting? I am giving one pixel label to it. And last is accuracy report, right? Assessment of accuracy for my technique. So all the features, land cover, land use, what I want to make, I'm going to make by using supervised classification technique. Next, we are going to discuss about what is unsupervised classification technique. Basically, here software itself going to take the automated classes by itself. When I'm giving the input of image, the software itself will identify the various classes and it will take the classes accordingly. Right? Sometimes it happens in unsupervised that it is misclassified, and if it is misclassified, we have to reclassify and we have to give the classes according to the pixel values, according to the neighboring pixel values, and we are going to check the accuracy assessment report. So this is known as unsupervised classification technique. Supervised and unsupervised both are there for the image analysis, but supervised classes been given by us, and in unsupervised software itself going to take the classes. So here image, clusterings of pixels, that what are the clusters behind it, we are going to give the pixel labeling, clusterings, natural clusterings, and last is accuracy assessment. Now let's take an example for supervised classification. You can see here the image of your, for example, 2000 I have taken. And the very next image to it, you can see the bright red color. In that, I have applied the supervised classification. What is that? I have taken the various classes. But looking to the image, can you see that both are ultimately having the common features only? But what is red color being shown in the raw image is generally showing the red color in our supervised classification technique. But it is not every time true that these are the correct classification done by us. We need to do the verification of it. Next, I have taken the image of 2011, right? You can see here, even here, the color combinations are given by us, that it been showing that how this class is been identified. Now, here I have shown the color and the pixel values of red, blue and green bands, and you can see how is the area and classification been done. So this is supervised, in which I have given the classes. You can see the urban, wasteland, fallow, salty land, that is what I have identified the classes as per my requirement with the given colors. But every time I cannot assist that this is the true. For this I need to check the accuracy report. Now let's discuss about the unsupervised classification. What is unsupervised classification? You can see here I have taken the raw image, and beside that you can see I have just applied the unsupervised, in which there is a mathematical formulas, that is ISO clusters, K statistics, that is what is applied behind it, and they have identified the classes by itself. Now I have to identify the classes which has been identified the software itself is right or wrong. For that I am giving here, you will see the verification image. What does this verification show? This verification shows that what are the pixel in the raw image is same in the image which is processed by the software, that is unsupervised. You can see here, right? So this is how classes are identified. Easy is the unsupervised, because you don't have to create the classes. Classes are created by the software itself. You have to just give the number of classes. From this image, I want 8 classes. So 8 different pixel values, it will be bifurcating your whole image into 8 classes, right? So this is how is unsupervised and supervised both. So supervised, we are going to analyze the classes. In unsupervised, software itself going to analyze the classes. We have to do the verification of it. Now I'm going to discuss about the accuracy reports of supervised and unsupervised. Yes, you don't have to go much detail into it, but yes, accuracy reports are formed by the software itself. You have to just check the percentage into it, and yes, you have to just check one, that is the Kappa statistic should not be more than one. And then if we can see that it is not more than one, then our classification is accurate, right? So this is how you can do. I have shown here the supervised and unsupervised. How much is urban, how much is water body, what are the areas in water body, how much area is covered, right? Looking to this, now from this accuracy report you can do the analysis. So image which I have done, the supervised and unsupervised, see here, I have shown you here what are the classifications behind it, how much area is increased or decreased is what my analysis from the image classification technique. So this is how I can classify my image, and I also have the accuracy report of it, and then only we can verify that what we have identified features are wrong or right, right? So we have various numbers of indices also. If I want to calculate only the built up area, I can calculate it by applying just an formula on the image. So I'm just playing with the bands of image and I can get the information of it, right? What area in urban you are getting will be the accurate area, that is what on the ground right now. So this is the major benefit of image interpretation and digital image processing. So thank you very much. Interpreting image, I guess, is very important, and you have understood now that digital image processing is important. After analyzing the image, then only after giving the filters, after enhancing the image, then only we can integrate finally with the GIS and we can get some output of it. So here, digital image processing and image interpretation, both are very important, because we are spending such a money on the satellites and satellite preparation. So we need to know about the importance, that what image we are taking from satellite should have some importance on it and should have some output from it, and that output is obtained by these things, that first we need to interpret, then we need to apply the digital tools on it, and then we can finally get the accurate output from it. Then only this technology is helpful, right? So this is what is image interpretation. Why is, I guess now you have got why fundamental of remote sensing was much important, because it is related much to this digital image processing. So this part is basically related to remotely sensed data, that is the satellite from which we are taking the information. Any satellite image, you have to apply all these things, and then only your image is said to be properly corrected, right? Because every time your eyes cannot identify all the features, and that is why you have to provide the classification techniques. Thank you.